oftentimes in public health, we talk about kind of a four-step approach to addressing any particular problem. And the first step is really the data and the surveillance. Do we know how much of it exists? Do we know what populations? Do we know that it occurs more in males or in females or maybe in teenagers or middle-aged adults or maybe in older adults? So the way we can better understand and explain what the patterns are helps us in terms of moving towards the next steps, which involve understanding and developing the prevention programs, which is really where we want to go. There are a number of different challenges that communities face in regards to getting the most relevant information about what's going on in their community. Oftentimes, national data is available, but that doesn't always give the full picture of what's happening locally. One example is, you know, when we look at the national average of suicide rates in the United States, that oftentimes the Rocky Mountains are some of the highest states that we've got. And for many, many decades, when we rank the states and look at which states are the top 10 or 15 in regards to suicide rates, that the Rocky Mountain states tend to be the highest. But when you look within those Rocky Mountain states, you can find certain counties that are much lower than the national average. So it's important for those people in those counties and those people in those states to be able to have data that is the most appropriate for their communities and for their populations. There are a number of different kind of levels of data that communities might want to have. Oftentimes, death certificates are available, but they only give you a small piece of the picture. We oftentimes talk about something called a pyramid in regards to the different kinds of information that's available. And the very tip of the pyramid are deaths. You'll have even more hospitalizations that are due to suicidal behavior, and that is, of course, more serious suicide attempts. Then you also have emergency department visits that are due to suicide attempts. That's an even bigger number. And then when we've done surveys that are population-based surveys in which we ask people in the past 12 months or over your lifetime, have you made a suicide attempt or thought about suicide? So we ask about suicidal thoughts and suicidal behavior. That's an even bigger picture, and that gets down to the base of the pyramid. Definitely getting access to already existing data is an important step. Sometimes there are folks in local communities who don't know about data that's already being collected, so that, you know, as we talk about, you don't have to reinvent the wheel. If it's already there, just finding access to it. Who's holding this data? Which organizations, which groups already have information that you might be able to use? And that may involve, you know, developing partners, developing collaborations with other groups. And so with local communities, they'll often have access to death certificate data from their state or their county vital statistics department. Maybe the local coroner or medical examiner might get you information or more information about deaths that occur due to suicides. Maybe working with local law enforcement that may have responded to a death due to suicide. One of the areas in which we've been able to help expand the amount of information that's available is the National Violent Death Reporting System. It includes information from death certificates, includes information from medical examiners and coroners, and then also includes information from law enforcement. Local hospitals will have information about inpatient data, and those are the people who are hospitalized due to suicide attempts. They will oftentimes have that information. There are state hospital associations that oftentimes are willing to share information about inpatient data. And so you may be able to go to one of those state hospital associations, find out information from them, work, develop partnerships in that way. There's information that's collected at the federal level. One of those data systems is called HCUP system, and that's a healthcare utilization project that has a national inpatient sample as well as an emergency department sample. And so for many states, although not all states, but many states, there's information in that HCUP data. There are databases like the National Survey on Drug Use and Health, the Youth Risk Behavior Survey that does high school students, in which sometimes communities can get that kind of information. I think that there are some critical things that in the field of suicide prevention that people in local communities really need to know. One is expanding the data so that you look beyond, where you can, beyond just deaths due to suicide. Where can you look for information about suicide attempts and non-fatal suicidal behavior? I think another place is the partnerships, because I think the partnerships actually help you be more effective in targeting those vulnerable populations for improving their health outcomes.